Denver 7 On Demand is brought to you by Ferguson and BAC Appliance Center, the best in bath, kitchen, and lighting for your home.
I'm Shannon Ogden with the latest from Denver 7. We hope you have enjoyed 2 days without driving in the snow, because it's going to be back again tomorrow. Chief Meteorologist Mike Nelson is tracking it for you tonight. Mike?
There's a big storm coming in from Arizona, same one that dropped snow in Las Vegas, Nevada. It's coming our way by morning. Snow covered and slippery out in the mountains. Light snow and freezing drizzle along I-70 and farther to the north. It gets a little bit better during the midday hours on Friday, but then this storm really starts to move on through late in the day into early Saturday. So it's going to be slick off and on during the day on Friday, 35 for a high. Windy and clearing Saturday as the storm rapidly moves to the east of us, and then it gets better for a while, 45 on Sunday, and some 50s coming up next week. Shannon?
All right, thank you, Mike. A third incident in just 2 days for Centennial Airport. This time, a plane ran off the edge of the runway into a ditch. Take a look at that. One person was hurt, but it's unclear just how badly. Yesterday, two small planes had hard landings, and in those cases, nobody was hurt. Well, Denver 7 has confirmed Governor Polis plans to sign a bill that ditches the Electoral College system. So Democrats of the State House and the State Senate have approved a plan to give all of our electoral votes, 9 of them, to whichever presidential candidate fares the best in the national popular vote. Now, no Republicans voted for the bill, and several Dems actually voted against it, too. This would only take effect if enough states sign on, and even with Colorado, we're still about 100 votes away from this happening. The governor has 10 days to sign it, and he does intend to do so. What's known as the red flag bill is being heard right now in the General Assembly. This would allow families or law enforcement to seek a court order to remove guns from people deemed to be a threat to themselves or to others. That person could petition to get their guns back. Now, the bill is opposed by some Second Amendment advocates, but it has the support of Democrats and at least two prominent Colorado sheriffs. We're going to keep a very close eye on this one as it moves through the legislature. And if you'd like, I encourage you to watch our 360 report on the denverchannel.com. If you live in the metro, there's a pretty decent chance your neighborhood briefly sounded like a militarized zone late last night. And if you somehow missed it, don't worry, it's going to happen again tonight. People in Aurora, Arvada, Westminster, Glendale, and Denver, Stapleton, and Lodo neighborhoods all reported helicopters buzzing over their homes. They were Blackhawks from Fort Campbell, Kentucky. And something we just learned tonight, and something neighbors certainly weren't expecting when their walls started shaking. Law enforcement says the helicopters are so big, it actually makes them sound like they're flying lower than they really are. Also, they ask you, please don't call 911.
Last night, between the hours of 10 and 11, Westminster, Jefferson County, all those dispatch centers started receiving a bunch of telephone calls. And what that does is it takes those operators away from the ability to answer emergency incoming calls.
All right, so take note, these helicopters will fly from 7 to 11 p.m. through the 26th, but could quiet down after Saturday. Our Colorado is growing by the minute, it seems, from the biggest cities to the smallest towns. As Denver 7's Jackie Crayer reports, Severance is the latest area to see a population boom.
Jennifer Prahl and her husband moved to Severance for the space.
I think there was about 3,000 people here or so. It was very attractive because it was kind of like, you know, what everybody says, now that we're here, we don't want anyone else to move here type of thing, but that's not realistic.
The country living, though, might change now that more people are coming to Severance to enjoy the same thing.
It's just gone bananas in the last couple of years.
Developers are making plans all around the area, including close to the Fox Ridge subdivision where Jennifer lives. Even a new high school to accommodate 1,200 students.
We're working with lots of buyers in Severance right now. And
real estate agent Eric Thompson says more people are coming for good reason. A single family home on average costs $362,000. That's $100,000 less than a single family home in Fort Collins.
Maybe 10 years ago, it was viewed as this far away, very separate, kind of siloed place. Now it's viewed as a connected suburb of Fort Collins.
But Prahl worries Severance could lose its quaint and quiet appeal.
That's progress, and that's the way it is. And, you know, the little old Prahl family ain't gonna stop anything.
But with the growing pains we see all over Colorado, there's plenty of upside.
There's gonna be new parks, there's gonna be new sidewalks, there's gonna be a four-lane road. We can't stop it. We might as well just accept it and enjoy it and just look at it as how it's going to improve our home values and improve the town of Severance as a whole.
In Weld County, Jackie Crea, Denver 7.
And we'd love to hear about you, especially if you live in Severance. Are you excited? Are you terrified? Are you both about all this new development in our Colorado? Please email us your thoughts at ourco@thedenverchannel.com. And this has been a Denver 7 On Demand update. Thanks for joining us. Check back later. We'll have another one for you. And download the Denver 7 app. We'll have breaking news and alerts there. I'm Shannon Ogden.